تزريع متسرع. A biblical portion opens with a very strange law. A woman who gives birth to a male child is tumeah, ritually apart from her husband for 7 days, just like when she menstruates and biblically is apart for her husband from her husband for 7 days. What does this tum'ah really mean? What is this ritual apartness, sometimes called ritual impurity? Where does it come from? Why does it affect the woman who menstruates, and why does it affect the woman who gives birth? Let me begin by trying to understand what the basic notion of biblical tum'ah is all about. If I were to look for a conceptual scheme to explain a concept which is foreign to the modern ear, but which was not at all foreign to ancient peoples, ancient religions, ancient cultures, the tum'ah par excellence, the most extreme type of tum'ah, is a dead body. It's called avi avot ha-tum'ah, the ultimate mother of ritual impurities, a corpse. And this is because Judaism is a religion of life. And Judaism even commands in the most profound way possible, v'chai bahem, you must live by our laws. And life is good, and you must embrace it. And anything which leads towards death, and certainly death itself, renders one in a state of ritual apartness for at least 7 days. Now, therefore, you can begin to understand many different examples of what is ritually impure and causes ritual apartness. Contact with a leprous person, it may not be the disease leprosy that we know today, but it was some disease in which the skin was wasted away and the individual looked like living death. The carcass of an impure animal, of a reptile. All of this leads to ritual apartness. All of this reminds one of death. And to a certain extent, that's true of menstruation as well. Because biologically speaking, each month, there is the possibility in a developed woman that her ovum can be fertilized. Conception can occur, and she can have a baby. And her body, in her womb, builds up blood cells to nourish the fetus if conception will take place. If the period of ovulation has passed and conception does not take place, then these blood cells that were there for potential life burst, and that's menstrual blood. And that therefore becomes a sign of life that could have sprung up within the woman's body and didn't do so. It's a movement away from life. And therefore, it brings about ritual apartness or ritual impurity. How does childbirth figure in this? In the case of childbirth, this is life par excellence. But you have to remember that every childbirth contains within it a brush with death. Until you hear the baby cry. And it's important, you know, until the very, very last period. The majority of women who died, died in childbirth. And therefore, this is precisely what the law is teaching us. Following the period of ritual impurity or separateness that comes after birth is a much longer period of purity, complete purity, even if there is blood. Because after all, we're talking about the birth of life. But nevertheless, our conceptual scheme holds true. What is therefore the antidote to ritual impurity, to separateness? The antidote is called a mikveh. When the woman ritually immerses herself in a spring of living waters, of waters that keep replenishing, not stagnant waters, but living waters. Mayim chayim, waters of life. And this is all in order for the woman to really be in touch with her body. Because we believe that people are holistic and that the physical affects the psychological, the mental. And that when menstruation occurs, there is a certain sense, not only within the hormones of the woman, within the mentality of the woman, that the chance at life has ebbed away for this month. She has to recognize it and therefore go through a period of separation and then ritually immerse herself in the waters of rebirth with the embracing of life once again as the movement towards ovulation will begin once again as part of the eternal life cycle. It appears to me that what the Bible is doing is helping the woman to be in touch with her body, in touch with herself, and very positively disposed towards living and embracing life with all of its hope and all of its renewal. Shabbat Shalom.